Hello friends, we were doing equations reducible to exact differential equations, okay? And in my previous sessions I have discussed type 1, that is of homogeneous type in which the equations were reducible, okay? Now today we are going to discuss about type 2. So what is a type 2? Equations of the form y into f1 xy dx plus x into f2 xy dy equal to 0. That means those equations in which we can take y common from the m part and x from the n part, okay, they lie in the type 2. For these type of equations, the multiplier, that is the integrating factor, that is 1 upon mx minus ny, with a condition mx minus ny is not equal to 0. In the previous case, in case of homogeneous, it was 1 over mx plus ny. Now we have mx minus ny, okay? So we are going to discuss a question from this part. So question is, y plus xy square dx plus x minus of xy dy equal to 0. So this is the question, okay? Let us name it equation number 1. Now, first of all, well, we have to check whether this equation is exact or not, okay? So, comparing equation 1 with mdx plus mdy equal to 0. So, what is the value of m? That will be y plus xy square, and the value of n will be x minus of x square y. So, since it is have a positive sign, it is a negative sign, so it is when we take derivatives, so it will be clear that it will not equal, but we have to perform the rule over there. So curly m upon curly y is equal to 1 plus 2xy, and curly m by curly x will be 1 minus of 2xy. Now look, because of positive and negative sign, both are not equal. This implies curly m over curly y is not equal to curly n by curly x. That means equation 1 is not exact. If it is not exact, that means we have to first of all reduce it to exact, and then we have to find its solution. Okay. Now look at the equation. Can we take y common from the first part? Since it is not a homogeneous part, so that means root 2 will be applicable. Okay. So we can take y common from the first part and x common from the second part. Okay. Now, given equation 1 is of the type y f1 xy dx plus x f2 xy dy equal to 0. Okay. So therefore, integrating factor is equal to 1 over mx minus of ny. So what is the result for this one? So m is y plus xy square, that part, into x minus of n. N is this one. So x minus of x square y into y. So it comes out to be 1 upon y into x xy plus x square y square minus of xy minus and minus plus x square and y square. So this xy and xy cancel out. So what we get? We get 1 upon x square y square with a twice, because this one and this one adds up. Okay. So now multiplying equation 1 with integrating factor. Okay. So this was your equation 1. Y plus xy square over 2x square y square dx plus x minus of x square y over x square y square with the term 2, dy equal to 0. So this reduces to be 1 by 2 x square and y, because y and y square. So here we have 1 by 2 x, y square cancel out. So this will be your m. Now x upon 2 x square y square will be 1 upon 2 x y square minus of x square and x square cancel, y upon y square, that will be 1 by 2y dy equal to 0. That will be equation number 2. Now we have to check whether this equation is exact or not. Okay, for that part we have to check the rule of exactness. So we are going, now we are going to compare this equation with m1 dx. Comparing equation 2 with m1 dx plus n1 dy equal to 0. So value of m1 will be 1 upon 2 x square y plus 1 upon 2x, and the value of n1 will be 1 upon 2x y square minus 1 upon 2y. Okay, so now we have to differentiate partially m1 with respect to x. Okay, no, sorry, with respect to y. So 1 upon 2x square will be constant, so 1 upon 2x square will be a constant. Derivative of 1 upon y will be minus 1 upon y square. Now derivative of this part will be 0. Curly n1 by curly x. So 1 by 2 y square will be constant. Now derivative of 1 upon x will be minus 1 upon x square. Derivative of 1 upon 2y, this is a constant, so its derivative will be 0. Now look, these two terms are equal. That means curly m1 by curly y is equal to curly n1 by curly x. This means equation 2 is exact and its solution is given by, its solution is given by integral of m1 dx keeping y constant plus integral of n not containing terms of x dy is equal to c. Okay, so what is m1? This is the part of m1. Integral keeping y constant, 1 upon 2 x square y plus 1 by 2 of x dx plus integral of n1 not containing terms of x. Since this part contains an x, so that means this part we have to exclude. Okay, so it will be 0. Minus 1 upon 2y. Minus 1 upon 2y dy is equal to c. So we have to integrate. So when we are integrating respect to x, so 1 upon 2y will be constant. 1 upon 2y will be a constant. We have 1 upon x square. 1 upon x square means x is to power minus of 2. So it will be x is to minus 2 plus 1 over minus 2 plus 1. Plus 1 by 2. Integral of 1 upon x will be log of x. Then we have minus 1 by 2. Integral of 1 upon y will be log of y is equal to c. So it will be 1 upon minus 2 plus 1 will be minus 1 upon 2x and y plus 1 by 2 common in both the terms. So I take common log x minus log of y is equal to c. Since 2 is present in both of the terms, so I will multiply this equation with 2. So the result will be minus 1 upon xy plus 2 upon 2 cancel out. Log m minus log n. So it will be log of m upon n is equal to 2c. So this equation can be rewritten as x upon y is equal to c1, where c1 is equal to 2c. So this is the solution of the given differential equation, which was not exact. Okay? X square y cube plus x y square plus y dx plus x cube y square minus of x square y plus x dy equal to 0. So this is a second question of the same type 2. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to first of all comparing equation 1, so let it be equation number 1, with mdx plus mdy equal to 0. So value of m will be x square y cube plus x y square plus y, and value of n will be x cube y square minus of x square y plus of x. So curly m by curly y, that means partial derivative of m with respect to y, keeping x as a constant. So y cube will be 3x square y square plus 2xy plus 1, and curly n by curly x will be 3x square y square minus 2xy plus 1. Now look at both of the equation, both are not equal. Curly m by curly y is not equal to curly n by curly x. This implies equation 1 is not exact. If it is not exact, that means to find a solution, we have to first of all reduce it to an exact equation. Okay? Now, since it is not a homogeneous, 2 plus 1, 2 plus 3 will be 5, 1, 2 plus 1 will be 3, 1, then 5, then 3, and then 1. It is not a homogeneous equation. But I can take y common from this part and x from this part. That means it is of the type, since equation 1 is of the type yf1xy dx, that means we can take y common from the m part, plus x f2xy dy equal to 0. That means I can take x from the n part. Okay, therefore integrating factor will be 1 over mx minus of ny. So what is the value of m? That is x square y cube plus x y square plus y into x minus of n, x cube y square minus of x square y plus of x into y. So it comes out to be 1 over x square into x, x cube y cube plus x square y square plus x y minus of x cube y cube minus and minus will be plus x square y square minus of x y. So what is it? You cancel now. This part is cancelled by this part, and this one is cancelled by this one. So we are left with x square y square and x square y square. So finally we got integrating factor is as 1 upon 2 x square y square. Okay. So multiplying equation 1 by integrating factor. So x square y cube plus x y square plus y over 2 times x square y square dx plus x cube y square minus of x square y plus x over 2 times x square y square dy is equal to 0. Okay, so 1 by 2, x square upon x square cancel out, y cube over y square will be y, plus x upon x square will be 1 upon x, y square and y square cancel out, plus y 1 upon x square, y upon y square will be y, plus 1 by 2 again common, x cube over x square will be x, y square upon y square cancel out, minus of x square and x square cancel out, y upon y square will be 1 upon y plus x upon x square will be 1 upon x and y square dy equal to 0. Okay, so now we have to check whether this equation is exact or not. So let it be equation number 2. Comparing equation 2 with m1 dx plus n1 dy equal to 0. Okay, so what is the value of m1 now? That will be 1 upon 2 y plus 1 upon x plus 1 upon x square y, and the value of n1 will be 1 by 2 x minus 1 upon y plus 1 upon xy square. So curly m1 by curly y, 1 by 2 as it is, y 1, 1 upon x will be 0 because it is a constant, plus 1 upon x is a constant, 1 upon y will be minus 1 upon x square y square. Okay, now curly n1 by curly x, so x will have added to 1, minus 1 upon y is a constant, so its derivative will be 0. 1 upon y square as it is, and derivative 1 upon x will be minus 1 upon x square. Y square is a constant. So it comes out to be minus 1 upon 2x square y square. And here it comes out to be curly n1 by curly x will be 1 by 2 with a negative sign, and x square and y square. Now look at the both the terms, that both are equal. This implies curly m1 by curly y is equal to curly n1 by curly x. That means equation 2 is exact. Differential equation, if it is exact, so its solution, so we have to find the solution of this equation. Okay. So its solution is given by integral, keeping y constant, m1 dx plus integral of n1 not containing terms of x into dy equal to c. Okay, so keeping y as a constant, so what is the value of m1? M1 have value 1 by 2 into y plus 1 upon x plus 1 upon x square y dx plus integral of n1 not containing terms of x. This part contain x, so that means it has to be excluded. This we have to get here, we have to exclude. So we have 1 upon 2 minus 1 upon y, so minus 1 upon 2y dy is equal to c. Okay, 1 by 2 as it is, y is a constant, so integral of constant will be x, plus 1 upon x have integral log of x, plus 1 upon y as it is, x raised to minus 2, that will be minus 2 plus 1, minus 2 plus 1. Okay, minus 1 by 2 log of y is equal to c. So half of xy plus half of log of x, now minus 2 plus 1 will be minus, minus 1 upon x is minus 2 plus 1 will be 1 upon x, so 1 by 2 of xy minus 1 by 2 log of y is equal to c. Since all of the term is there is 1 by 2 present in every part, so I will multiply the whole of the equation with 2, so it will be xy minus 1 upon xy plus log m minus log n, so it will be log of m over n is equal to 2c. Or this equation can be rewritten as xy minus 1 upon xy plus log of x upon y is equal to c1, where c1 is equal to 2c. So this will be the answer of the given equation, which was not exact, but we have reduced that equation in an exact differential equation by multiplying an integrating factor. Okay, I think so it is.